Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. The MapleStory Korea community is up in arms. Some are even planning to send protest trucks to the Nexon Korea office demanding action to be taken. The MapleStory Global team posted a notice about this issue as well. However, at the time of this video, on the MapleStory C website, nothing has been posted regarding this issue yet. Long story short, there was a problem with the way the logic was working for flame stats and inner abilities. Flame stats are those green bonus stats on your items, and inner abilities are those potential stats your character has in the stat window. Because of this problem, some stats would appear more frequent together than others. There will be a compensation for this issue as well, which we will get into in a bit. But first, let's dive into what exactly the problem is over at the MapleStory Global notice, which gives us some good insights on how the issue works. Quoting from their notice, "To better explain the problematic aspects of the current logic, we would like to give you some more detailed information. The following is how bonus stats and inner ability stats are selected, operating in the following order. The first stat is selected according to weighted values for the bonus stats listed on the table below. The table is then split into two sections, top and bottom, based on the first stat's location on the table. Afterwards, one stat is selected according to the respective weight values for each of these two sections, top and bottom, as candidates. One of the two stats chosen from stat 3 is selected and set as a second stat. The third and fourth stat are selected in the same way. We have confirmed that the fourth step could cause high appearance rates for certain stats together depending on the first stat option that was selected. For example, if jump is selected as an armor item's first stat line, only all stats percentage will be chosen as one of the two options for the second stat line, increasing the odds of it being selected." End quote. So that means that the system favors some bonus stats more than others depending on the stats selected. And the same error applies to inner abilities. If you lock certain inner abilities, there will be a higher chance of some other abilities to appear. For example, if in your first slot you'd lock all stats increase, and in the third slot you lock strength to dex conversion, there is a higher chance for attack speed increase to appear in the second slot. Because Mable has figured this out recently as well, you can already see that the prices of honor medals have skyrocketed. By the way, if you are enjoying today's video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more MapleStory content. Make sure to hit that bell notification as well. Now, Nexon is planning to address this issue in GMS in the upcoming March maintenance, and they're working on a compensation plan as well, since the system was not exactly working as intended. In MapleStory Korea, a compensation plan was already announced earlier today, so perhaps we can look forward to something similar over here as well. In MapleStory Korea, Maples will receive rebirth flame points based on the type and number of flames used between February 2019 until February 24th of this year. Untradeable powerful rebirth flames are worth 0.1 point, untradeable eternal flames 0.3, and untradeable black flames 1. Also, depending on if the flame is tradable or not, the amount of points increases to 0.3 and 0.9. And the points for tradable flames are called points B, while the non-tradable flames are called points A. You can trade those points for new flames, and depending on the points that you're using, either A or B, those flames are tradable or untradable. For Maples that reset their inner ability through honor, they will get honor points as well depending on the amount of honor points spent. Also, if you for example use the Mulong medal to get 10k points, you'll get 0.1 medal points. So only after using 10 of those, you can get one more medal as compensation. However, Nexon did mention that all compensations will be rounded up, so 1.1 points becomes 2 points in total. Maples who board Miracle Circulators with NX Cash will be compensated with Maple points as well. One important thing to notice in this compensation is that the honor EXP of Maples who rerolled their inner ability from the 19th of February this year until the 24th of February while locking two ability lines will not be compensated. This only counts for this period though, they are still included in the compensation, just not for the honor spent during this time. I'm just guessing, but I think we can expect something similar to happen in MapleStory Global as well. Not sure yet for MapleStory C, since no notice has been posted yet, but looking at the seriousness of this issue, I can understand that it takes some time to draft a good notice. I think the transparency from the MapleStory Global team and the notice are good, but the developers really need to step up their game. Issues like this can lead to huge fines and a big loss in trust from us Maplers. So hopefully they can take this experience and turn it into something more positive. I hope everyone is a bit better informed now on this issue and the expected compensation. And that was all for today. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Jeff Wang, Pinky Traveler, Terry Kim, Jiju, Galaxy Art, Augustus Rodriguez, Varese, Ricer Ayu, Dries Sumker, Plux, Zenny, Wiley, Kevin Han, Francisco Salsa, History Canon, Backspace OTI, Riley Frank, Simak, Saffronix, Alonso, BG Extremes, Caveman, oh yeah, Harry Gardner, Estevao Silva, Ido Hyman, Anwar NHI, Brandon, Frank Puget, Ziggy Deer, Fine Asian Guy, Mr. Potemkin, and Flidiot. If you'd like to be mentioned here as well and get early access to new videos, make sure to check out the join button below this video. Thank you all so much for watching, stay safe, and happy mapling!